गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 12। सो 12th क्लास, 12th क्लास वी स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5 एंड रिवाइज चैप्टर नंबर 6। सो इन इनवर्स ऑफ मैट्रिक्स वी डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट डिफरेंट टॉपिक and then after we can explain some important theorem. What is the theorem? Let's see. We can explain a theorem. What is the theorem? Theorem third. That is the inverse matrix of a non-sigma matrix is a unit. Theorem is where the statement is given. Inverse matrix of non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix is unit. नॉन सिंगुलर मैट्रिक्स का जो इनवर्स होगा वो क्या होगा बेटा? यूनिक होगा। देन इन टू बिट इनिशियली वी कैन एज्यूम दैट A is a non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix of order n. And बेटा इसमें क्या है? यूनिक का मतलब एक ही होगा। किसी भी non-singular matrix का जो इनवर्स होगा इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि वो एक ही होगा। So, student of class 2, initially we can assume that non-sigma matrix have two inverse of matrix. And there are two inverse of matrix that is So you know that student of class 12, you know that if two matrix are given, one is the matrix, another is the inverse. You know that multiplication of two matrix, if identity matrix, then they are inverse of each other. So we can write down that is AB equal to I and AC equal to I. Second condition. Because B is the inverse of A and A is the inverse of A, so we can write down, it can be write down that is this condition. So student, in this process we can write down here, if these both are equal also. Here we can write down P A, here also we can write down P A. So from first is that A B and A C both are equal. So A and both are cancelled out, so we get P equal to C. Means if we can assume two different matrix, but if we can apply inverse condition, inverse of matrix, so it can be C. We can say P and C both are equal. So it means inverse of a matrix is unit. अपन ने अलग-अलग assume किया, लेकिन जब inverse matrix की हमने procedure apply की, तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि हमारे पास दोनों में equal to C आया। सो बी इक्वल टू अपन ने क्या अप्लाई कर दिया सेम, ठीक है। सो स्टूडेंट्स वी डिस्कस नेक्स्ट थ्योरम, व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट थ्योरम, दैट इज द नेक्स्ट थ्योरम, दैट थ्योरम नंबर 4। व्हाट इज द थ्योरम नंबर 4, देन सी व्हाट इज द थ्योरम नंबर 3, वी डिस्कस इन थ्योरम नंबर 4। इन थ्योरम So students, if A and B are non-singular matrix of same order, then AB whole inverse equal to B inverse A inverse, B inverse into A inverse. Then see. So students, in proofment, see how can we prove it? AB whole inverse equal to what is given? B inverse into A inverse. Then see. Students, all of you know that if we can multiply a matrix and get inverse, so we get that is the RNT matrix. Okay? Let's see here how can we prove it. This condition is given. AB whole inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse. Then see, students, we can write down multiply both sides by A. So we can write down AB whole inverse into A equals B inverse into क्या हो गया A inverse into क्या हो गया A. तो AB whole inverse then into AB क्या हो गया I. यहाँ पे simplify करेंगे B inverse ये A inverse into A inverse matrix. तो इधर is the matrix. So also product of A inverse and A, that is the identity. So if RHS is I, RHS, this is a I, you know that if we can multiply any matrix by unit matrix, so we get that is the same matrix. So left hand side is a, it is a B inverse into, so I equal to B inverse into. So two matrix, this is an inverse, this is a matrix, so product term is also here. In this way, we can write down LHS equal to. So student of class 12, in this way, we completed 10th theorem number 4. So student of class 12, thereafter, we enter an exercise, that is in 5.5. Okay, so see an exercise of 5.5. Let's see. Then exercise 5.1. In exercise 5.1, how can we prove it? Let's see. In 5.1, first question, for what value of x matrix is given 1 minus 1 2 3 0. Just understood first question, we have 1 minus 2 3 1 2 1 x 2 and minus 3 is singular. Ye kya hota is singular, So student of class 12, you know that what is a singular matrix? If value of determinant is 0, so it is a singular matrix. Then this matrix A, if singular, we can change in determinant from 1, minus 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, x, 2, and minus 2. So determinants, because it is a singular, such that matrix is singular. It means determinant of A equal to 0. Determinant A equal to 0. So we can apply 1, minus 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, x, 2, minus 3, equal to 0. First we can expand 1, first column cancel, minus 6, minus 2. Second, plus, minus, plus, that is a plus 2. Second row, first column, minus 3, minus 6. Plus third row, first column cancel, that is a 2 minus 12, 0. It is minus 8, minus 6, minus 2. Plus 6, minus 6. Plus 6, minus 6 cancel. It is a minus 8, it is a minus 8, x, 0. So minus 8 equal to 8. So x equal to negative 1. So in this way, student of class 12, we can find out if any matrix be singular. So you can assume that this determinant is 0. So student, in question number second, if matrix given है, find adjoint. Adjoint का मतलब आपको explain कर रखा है, ये verify करना है. तो second question बेटा आप try करें. Third question है, find the non-singular matrix of the following. Means you have need to find out its determinants. If determinants of it does not equal to 0, so we can find check if determinant does not equal to 0. So it is a non-singular matrix. In question number 4. What is given question number 4? Let's see. Then see question number 4. Matrix A, yani ki F, if exponents cos of 4 minus sine of 4 and 0. Sine of 4 cos of 4 and 0. 0, 0, 1. Then find A and prove that A inverse into AI, second form, A inverse equal to minus F, and third power, that is A, and third power, A into adjoint form, determinant of A into equal to adjoint of A into इस पे होगा समझ से स्टूडेंट्स. सो सो स्टूडेंट्स इन 5.1 फर्स्ट वी हैव फाइंड आउट एक्स. First we can find out determinants of A. A change करेंगे cos of 4 minus sin of 4 0. Sin of 4 cos of 4 0 and 0 0 क्या हो गया. Then after expand करेंगे तो बेटा क्या होगा cos of 4 first row cos of 4 minus 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 just finite form. You can see. Multiply current. Final form minus. It is a cos square alpha plus sin square alpha, that is a 1. Means our determinants of A does not equal to. Thereafter we can find out its cofactor, because first we have need to find out inverse, then we can find out cofactor. How can you find out cofactor? Yes. First A11, first row, first column can cos alpha 0, 0 or 1. So kya gaya cos alpha? A12 negative lenge. First row, second column cancel. Sin alpha 0, 0 or 1. Ye kya gaya? Minus hota hai. Minus sin. Second, A third, A13. Cancel out. क्या होगा साइन अल्फा कॉस अल्फा 0 0 वैल्यू क्या होगी 0 a 2 1 नेगेटिव लेंगे सेकंड रो एंड फर्स्ट कॉलम कैंसिल माइनस साइन अल्फा 0 0 एंड 1 माइनस बार है माइनस साइन अल्फा माइनस 0 क्या हो गया a 2 2 क्या लेंगे पॉजिटिव फर्स्ट रो ये दोनों कैंसिल जब कैंसिल करेंगे फर्स्ट और सेकंड कॉलम कैंसिल होगा तो ये क्या हो गया cos alpha 0 और 0 होगा क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट किया क्या दिया बड़ा इसी तरह हम क्या निकालेंगे a 2 3 निकालेंगे ये भी क्या होता है नेगेटिव साइन क्या होता है इसका नेगेटिव माइनस करते हैं प्लस माइनस प्लस प्लस माइनस प्लस माइनस प्लस माइनस प्लस थर्ड रो सेकंड कॉलम कैंसिल क्या हो गया cos alpha sin 0 एंड 0 वैल्यू 0 a 3 1 लेंगे थर्ड रो फर्स्ट कॉलम कैंसिल माइनस sin alpha 0 cos alpha 0 वैल्यू क्या हो गया 0 a 3 2 लेंगे नेगेटिव में आएगा सेकंड रो तो cos alpha 0 सेकंड रो और थर्ड रो सेकंड कॉलम फिक्स और sin alpha 0 वैल्यू क्या होगी 0 a 3 3 लेंगे पॉजिटिव आएगा थर्ड रो थर्ड कॉलम कैंसिल cos alpha माइनस sin alpha sin alpha cos स्क्वायर अल्फा प्लस sin स्क्वायर अल्फा क्या होगा तो इस तरह से हमारे पास क्या होगा a11 cos alpha a12 minus sin alpha a13 a21 sin alpha a22 cos alpha और यह Thereafter, adjoint of A जब निकालेंगे तो adjoint of A क्या हो गया C transpose चेंज कर दे cos sin alpha 0 minus sin alpha cos alpha 0 और 0 So student you know that A inverse equal to 1 by determinants of A into adjoint. अब determinants of A था adjoint of A as it is calculating cos alpha sin alpha 0 minus sin alpha cos alpha 0 और ये बन जाएगा ये अब से फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड पार्ट में आप रिप्लेस कर दें प्रोवाइड कर दें आंसर आपका आ जाएगा Okay, so thank you so much. We discussed other questions.